Welcome to our Grand Rapids showroom. I'm Stefan Schwartz, the product manager for Ironwood Machinery, and here we're taking a look at the Ironwood Cut 18 Crosscut Saw. This is an excellent, compact, safe, and accurate solution for cross-cutting, whether you're doing lumber, non-ferrous metals like aluminum or brass, plastics, packaging materials, MDF, mahogany, you name it, this saw is capable of cutting it to accurately and safely and repeatably as well. So for a consistent and accurate cut here, we're gonna use a couple of different things. Our saw is pneumatically operated, so first and foremost, when my operator hits the foot pedal, our safety guard will come down, clamping the workpiece and securing it firmly to the table so that we had a square cut every time, as well as to the desired length we have. Secondly, the blade will traverse up through the cut, so the upcut gives it a very clean cut, a very accurate cut, and once the blade retracts post-cut, the clamp will then release, allowing the operator to then feed the next piece in or to move on to a secondary operation. In addition to our clamping system, you'll see our safety guards to the left and right of the machine cutting area, keeping the operator's hands completely away from the cutting area at all times. Safety for us in the Ironwood world is a very paramount concern, as it is for most of you shop owners and woodworkers at home. In addition to the foot pedal, you can also retrofit this machine with a dual hand controlled operation, meaning that I have to press two buttons simultaneously in order to cycle the saw, further removing my hands from the cutting operation altogether. Again, an excellent compact solution for cross-cutting repeatably, accurately, and safely every time. All right, taking a look at the controls and the operator infeed for our Cut 18, we've got a couple of very simple operations here. We've got our main power disconnect. You'll see this machine's obviously on as the light has illuminated here. Our cycle air for the saw pneumatic operation, as well as our guard air here. So once I flip those both, the guard will come up automatically, basically saying it's ready for the cut. On the infeed side, in order to keep operators even further away, we've got these little finger keys as well. I can tighten these down and loosen these, raise these up, basically to keep people from entering the cutting area, but I can also adjust these to the width of my piece. So if I've got a thin work piece, I can drop these down and just run smaller profiles, whereas if I'm cutting some wider lumber, I can raise two or three of them up and get my entire piece fed in here. The back fence here is going to square our cut going in towards the cutting area so that I get a great square cut every time. So taking a look at the front end of the machine where the operator would be in the position, with the back fence squaring the cut, we've got an emergency stop placed ergonomically right here for simple and easy operations to be able to stop anything. As safety is paramount in the Ironwood world, this can be hit with a hand, a knee, a thigh, whatever, in the event that anything is compromised during the operation of the saw. As well, on the bottom, you'll see the pneumatic foot pedal here, which activates the guard for the saw, as well as the cutting cycle. So when I hit this, the guard will come down, the blade will traverse up through the cut, the blade will then release, come back into the saw, and then the guard will release, completing the cut. So this entire time that the saw is traversing up and down through the material, that is the exact frame of time in which the guard is also clamped down. So at no point is the saw blade traversing through any of my material while the guard isn't holding it down. So the workpiece stays secure the entire time during the cutting operation. Taking a look at the inside of the machine, we've got our airflow control valves here that are going to control the cycle speed, the speed in which we traverse through the material, as well as the speed in which the guard comes up and down. Because these saws spin at a constant RPM, our cut quality is really based on how we traverse through the material, how quickly or how slowly. So for denser material, obviously, I want to slow it down a little bit, whether that's brass, solid aluminum rod, or even plastics with a low melting point. I don't want to create too much friction and melt the material. Versus something like lumber, MDF, solid woods, I don't have a problem speeding that up at all to be able to have shorter cycle times. So these flow control valves at the top and the bottom are going to control the speed in which the clamp comes down, the saw traverses through the material up and down, and releases as well. So I can control kind of a combination of how fast I clamp and how quickly I release in order to keep my cycle times down, but also control the cut quality as well. Now, in a plastics and metals version, I have an air over oil cylinder. The oil is going to be a little bit denser than the air and give us a smoother saw stroke for better controllability during the cutting cycle. So taking a look at the left-hand side of our saw, you'll see the blade cavity here. Our blade is completely isolated from the rest of our interior components, which one, gives us a better dust extraction for a cleaner work environment, but also two, allows us easy access for blade changes and tooling options. Once this saw is completed, its cut cycle up and down, the blade continues to spin, and with interlocking door systems here, this door remains locked on a timer basis until the blades come to a complete stop, making sure that the operator is safe at all times and that no one can gain access to this cavity while the blade's moving. So with our cross-cutting solutions, it's very important to take into consideration the fact that we're sizing much larger material down to much smaller material, right? So while we're cutting to size, we want to do a couple of different things. Whether you're pairing this with some sort of automatic positioner, right, like a Tiger Stop, for instance, that's pushing my material in from an in-feed perspective, or whether I'm using something more manual and more simplistic like this setup here as a stop. I've just got a simple back fence, a manual scale, and a manual stop as well, so that if I'm cutting my front drawer boxes at 12 inches, I can put this here. If I'm cutting longer styles and rails for cabinets, or sizing lumber for whatever job that I may be doing, I can move this stop as I see accordingly, right? Keep in mind, there are different and more advanced systems that pair with these saws as well as I step up. In the world of the Tiger Stop, for instance, I've got optimization to increase my material yield as well as reduce my labor costs, but this is no different, right? Being able to cross-cut consistently and accurately every time is helping my bottom line by making sure that I'm not spending too much time on a saw that doesn't need that much time, as well as with the rising price of materials here, I'm able to use the maximum amount of my board and save those extra pennies, as well as use my offcuts for different jobs down the line as well. So having a logistical stacking point or stopping point here for this is a very paramount process in the cross-cutting solution. And this is only a 4-foot table, right? If I had much longer material, these can be stackable. They come in 4 and 8 foot lengths. I can easily pair these with any automated positioning system, or just keep things manual and at a very cost-effective solution to doing repeatable cross-cuts that are accurate and consistent every time for my operation.